So in this video, I want to share my thoughts on the book Brave New World by Aldous Huxley, which is a book that I believe needs no introduction because of it, how popular and how classic it has become. Basically, everyone refers to this book when they want to talk about anything. It's a very important book, and I came into the picture late, because I didn't really read it until, I don't know, a few months ago. But it is a very important book. When I read it, three questions came into mind. And I'll just assume that you already read the book because it is such a renowned book. And the three questions that came to mind were these questions: which is the Brave New World, the one that the savage lives in, or the one in which the society has, the society that has no sadness because it's designed by humankind to not have sadness in it? And in the book's perspective, because it takes the perspective of the savage a lot, it seems to be that the society that's being described in the book, not savage world, is the Brave New World. But of course, maybe as a reader, because we are more familiar with this kind of society, because perhaps it can be said that we are heading, perhaps Aldous Huxley was saying that we are headed to this kind of future. Brave New World is actually the one that the savage lived in, more primitive and more with nature, more barbaric, I guess, so to say. The second question is: is this society technologically and politically possible or feasible even? And of course, the answer is, of course, no. But I just want to kind of discuss, the possibilities of what happens in the book. We're still far, far away from anything like that society, but thinking about, well, is it possible for it to be like that is, I think, an important question. And the final question, of course, is a no-brainer for many people. But is this society actually desirable, this brave new world? And of course, the answer is going to be for pretty much almost everyone, even for the author himself, Aldous Huxley. The answer is no. It's a world where sadness does not exist, but it's where everything is so controlled so that sadness does not exist. So let's go back to the first question: is this Brave New World? Which is the Brave New World? And I was always, very intrigued by this idea. The book kind of makes it so that we're taking the savage perspective because we are more, he is an alien to this new society. Everyone else has just become kind of, they've grown used to it. They've grown used to the fact that there is no family, there's no such thing as a mother, a father, there's no such thing as marriage. Everyone belongs to everyone. There's no such thing as class rebellion. Because if you're born, if you're a janitor, you're born as a janitor. Your genetic makeup has been altered so that you enjoy being that. And it's only when the people in the higher up positions, they're left to think. And I guess because they're able to think, they can have sadness. But because the society does not allow sadness, you take soma, which is this pill, So it's very, we're taking the point of the savage, who, this our world is so different from this brave new world that, of course, it's gonna feel like a brave new world, this society. Our world has known what the savage lived in. Historically, there has been societies very similar to what the savage lives in. So in a way, the book kind of makes it seem like this society is the Brave New World. But I think Aldous Huxley is also kind of saying that this is what our future might be. So this actually might not be Brave New World, but it actually might be very similar to society we're currently living in, especially in modern developed countries such as America and Britain and whatnot. We are doing everything we possibly can to eliminate sadness and to control ourselves and create laws and regulation, and to in some political parties will even say, we'll even justify the classes that are here, the kind of the institutions that are here. Everything is justified in order so that there is no sadness. And I think there's a lot of similarity between this society and the Brave New World society. So in a way, maybe the Brave New World is the more primitive one, the one where it's so much harder to see nowadays, except for or certain parts of the world that are still kind of like that. And even America, there are still parts of this country that are like that, which to us now feels more more strange and alien than the society we live in now. So I think that's an important point. Now to the next question, is this society possible? And the initial reaction to all these three questions would be no, of course. You know, which is the Brave New World? Of course, the Brave New World is a society that is controlled. And the obvious answer, of course, I guess, would be no, it's not possible. There's no way to clone people, first of all, because all the people in that society are clones. They're not born. They're cloned. And, you know, this whole idea of everyone belonging to everyone is so alien to many parts of developed countries. Even people who practice polygamy, I mean, this idea is crazy. A woman dating other men and men dating other women at the same time that they're dating each other. And they're just having sex like crazy because it's happy for them. But this whole, you know, all the systems in our world are so tightly guided by religion, by political systems, by institutions, that this kind of society is really politically impossible at this point. But I feel like, you know, it is a very it's a possible future politically, but technologically there are two barriers to this. One is, of course, genetic manipulation. It's not possible to clone, and it's definitely not possible to alter genetics so that we have these kind of human beings where, you know, a person IQ is this specific so that this person belongs in this job, and also some kind of person, a director of the world, controlling everyone's position. You know, this clone number 23, he's going to be a lawyer. This clone, and he's going to be trained from birth, even before birth, to be that. Which is just, that's a remarkable, I don't know, it's a really intriguing idea, and definitely not possible, at least not now. And I think it'll be a long time before that anything like that could become possible, technologically. Politically is a different issue. Another thing is, of course, the drug Soma. In our world currently, there's nothing like that. A drug that has no side effects whatsoever. There's no addiction symptom. Yet it makes you freaking happy. And it doesn't. If you take it, you know, it does inhibit your abilities quite a bit. But it's not like. Nothing like alcohol, nothing like marijuana. It's a drug that is completely makes you happy. You can take however, pretty much a lot. Although there is a character, the Savage's mother, gets so into obsessed with Soma that she just pretty much lives like she's dying, and she dies just like that. You know, in a technology where you don't age, I mean, this is a crazy society. If you think about it, and our technology is nowhere close to that, you know. And this brings us to the last question. If it is technologically possible, if it is politically possible, is this society desirable? And of course, an initial reaction, like the Savage, will be no. You know, this is such a crazy society. We have no religion. We have no spirituality. We have no thought process for majority of people because they're made to be that way, really. They're clones so that they enjoy their role in life, so that they don't question it, so that they don't rebel and cause problems. There is no sadness allowed. You know, if you get to thinking too much, you're encouraged to take Soma, to take the drug that will make you happy, and just go in life living that way. And if you are kind of the people that, you know, think too much and get sad, you're actually deported to this alien world, you know. And everyone belongs to everyone, so there is no actual love in a relationship. There's no love allowed. It's the kind of life where, you know, you're just happy to live, but there is no actual passion. There is no suffering. No, I think Aldous Huxley paints in this book that suffering is necessary in our society. You know, all the bad things. You know, we try to get rid of it, but it is kind of necessary. But what is And what does the world look like without any kind of sadness? By forcing sadness out of our lives, you know, it's a very interesting question, I think, especially with love relationships. It really made me question kind of what is the purpose of this kind of monogamy or even polygamy, even because polygamy in most polygamous societies, the men. Is able to have multiple wives, but the wives cannot have multiple husbands. So that's also regulation itself. in which this Brave New World Society doesn't have that regulation at all. You know, and it's just something interesting to think about, how the things that we take for granted, you know, that, you know, people have relationship with one other person, and if they start having a relationship with someone else, that's cheating. In Brave New World, there is no such thing as cheating. There's no such thing as a mother. It's just so intriguing and interesting. I think, you know, that's one of the books. And the one thing that really kind of irked me about the book was, of course, the Savage and how he reacted to the Brave New World. A lot of it makes sense. But then him going the totally opposite way and making himself suffer, you know, it's, well, the ending of the book, he commits suicide. That's one implication right there, that he just can't take it. But he can't take it because he goes the opposite route, where there is no happiness at all. He thinks he doesn't deserve any happiness. And he has this chivalrous notion, you know, but it's kind of crazy, because in a society where there is no sadness, he tries to live in a world where there is no happiness. And the end result is, of course, that he goes batshit crazy. So those are just my thoughts in the book. I know, as always, I ramble a lot, but, you know, that's what I do.